Good morning. You're all very welcome. This morning is our Holocaust Memorial Service. So there will not be any announcements this morning, only to announce that our service next week will continue at 11:30 as always. But this morning, our service will continue unannounced. Thank you. As we remember today the Holocaust, may we be reminded here of our highest aspirations and inspired to bring our gifts of love and service to the altar of humanity. May we know once again that we are not isolated beings, but connected in mystery and miracle to the universe, to this community, to each other. Let us pray. Let us worship with our eyes and ears and fingertips. Let us love the world through heart and mind and body. We feed our eyes upon the mystery and revelation in the faces of all our brothers and sisters. We seek to know the wistfulness of the very young and the very old, the wistfulness of people in all times and in all places. Amen. Now may we sing together our first hymn, Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone. Today's first reading is a poem by W.H. Auden entitled Refugee Blues. Say this city has 10 million souls. Some are living in mansions and some are living in holes. Yet there's no place for us, my dear. Yet there's no place for us. Once we had a country and we thought it fair. Look in the atlas and you'll find it there. But we cannot go there now, my dear. We cannot go there now. In the village churchyard, there grows an old yew. Every springtime, it blossoms anew. Old passports can't do that, my dear. Old passports can't do that. The consul banged the table and said, if you've got no passport, you're officially dead. But we're still alive, my dear. But we are still alive. Went to a committee, and they offered me a chair. Asked me politely to return next year. But where will we go now, my dear? Where will we go now? Came to a public meeting, and the speaker got up and said, if we let them in, they'll steal our daily bread. He was talking of you and me, my dear. He was talking of you and me. Thought I heard thunder in the skies. It was Hitler over Europe saying, they must die. Oh, we were in his mind, my dear. Oh, we were in his mind. Saw a poodle in a jacket fastened with a pin. Saw a door edge open and a cat wander in. But they weren't German Jews, my dear. They weren't German Jews. Went down to the harbour and stood upon the quay. Saw the fish swimming as if they were free. Only 10 feet away, my dear. Only 10 feet away. Walked through a wood, saw the birds in the trees. They had no politicians and sang at their ease. But they weren't the human race, my dear. They weren't the human race. Dreamed I saw a building with 1,000 floors, 1,000 windows and 1,000 doors. Not one of them were ours, my dear. Not one of them were ours. Stood in a great plain in the falling snow. 10,000 soldiers marching to and fro, looking for you and me, my dear. Looking for you and me.
Thank you.
In the spirit of the Stockholm Declaration that states, with humanity still scarred by anti-Semitism and xenophobia, the international community shares a solemn responsibility to fight those evils. The Committee on Anti-Semitism and Holocaust Denial, called the IHRA plenary in Budapest in 2015, the IHRA being the International Holocaust Remembrance Alliance. And they were called to adopt the following working definition of anti-Semitism. And then in 2016, the plenary in Bucharest decided on the following: to adopt the following non-legally binding working definition of anti-Semitism, which stated, anti-Semitism is a certain perception of Jews, which may be expressed as hatred towards Jews, rhetorical and physical manifestations of anti-Semitism are directed towards Jewish or non-Jewish individuals and or their property, towards Jewish community institutions and religious facilities. Now, before I share with you some of the guidelines from the International Holocaust Remembrance Alliance, it makes no sense if we every year hold Holocaust memorial services and then we refuse to tackle anti-Semitism that exists within all our communities. It is interesting to note that in the Philippines, where there are no Jews, the greatest hatred there is anti-Semitism. Anti-Semitism in our tradition, in our culture, is probably the oldest hatred and still exists today. I remember asking a friend of mine who was Jewish, had the Holocaust ended? To the greater extent, he said, but it still exists for many Jews in anti-Semitism throughout today. Sadly, throughout Europe, anti-Semitism is on the rise. Thankfully, many parliaments and assemblies have accepted the International Holocaust Remembrance Alliance definition. Westminster has endorsed it, the Scottish Parliament, and the Welsh Assembly. To my knowledge, it hasn't been fully endorsed in the Northern Ireland Assembly as yet, but has been introduced and the first reading accepted. I may stand corrected on that. But I do know there is some opposition to accepting these anti-Semitic guidelines from some politicians in Stormont. Let me share with you the guidelines. Manifestations might include the targeting of the State of Israel, conceived as a Jewish collectivity. However, criticism of Israel, similar to that leveled against any other country, cannot be regarded as anti-Semitic. Anti-Semitism frequently charges Jews with conspiring to harm humanity, and it is often used to blame Jews for why things go wrong. It is expressed in speech, writing, visual forms, and actions, and employs sinister stereotypes and negative character traits. Contemporary examples of anti-Semitism in public life, the media, schools, the workplace, and in the religious sphere could take into account an overall context, including, but are not also, not only limited to, and the following are those. Calling for, aiding, or justifying the killing or harming of Jews in the name of radical ideology or an extremist view of religion. There are still some Christians who blame the Jews for deicide in the killing of Jesus Christ. It is interesting that at the same time, Jews can be blamed for the spread of communism and also for being the masters of capitalism. Making mendacious, dehumanizing, demonizing, or stereotypical allegations about Jews, such are the power of Jews as a collective, such as especially but not exclusively the myth about world Jewish conspiracy of Jews controlling the media, economy, government, or other societal institutions. It'll not surprise many of you to know that Jews have been blamed for COVID. Accusing Jews as a people of being responsible for real or imagined wrongdoing committed by a single Jewish person or group, or even for acts committed by non-Jews. Denying the fact, scope, mechanisms, or intentionality of the genocide of the Jewish people at the hands of nationalist socialist Germany and its supporters and accomplices during World War II. In other words, the denial that the Holocaust ever happened. Accusing the Jews as a people, or Israel as a state, or of inventing or exaggerating the Holocaust. Accusing Jewish citizens of being more loyal to Israel or to the alleged priorities of Jews worldwide than to the interests of their own nations. Forgetting, of course, that in the First World War, thousands of Jews fought heroically for Germany and as patriotic Germans. Denying the Jewish people their right to self-determination by claiming that the existence of a state of Israel is a racist endeavor. The only people in the world who are continuously attacked for the right of self-determination are the Jewish people. Applying double standards by requiring of it a behavior not expected or demanded of any other democratic nation. Using the symbols and images associated with classic anti-Semitism to characterize Israel or Jewish people. Drawing comparisons of contemporary Jewish policy in Israel to that of the Nazis. Holding Jews collectively responsible for the atrocities committed by the State of Israel. Anti-Semitic acts are criminal when they are so defined by law. For example, as I stated, the denial of the Holocaust or the distribution of anti-Semitic material as it happens still in some countries legally. Criminal acts are anti-Semitic when the targets of attacks, whether they are people or property, such as buildings, schools, places of worship, and cemeteries. Only a few years ago, in City Cemetery in Belfast, Jewish graves were attacked. All of these are selected because they are or are perceived to be Jewish or linked to be Jewish. Shops in Paris were attacked because they were associated with members of the Jewish community. Anti-Semitic discrimination is the denial to Jews of opportunities or services available to others, and thankfully in many countries is now illegal. But there are still certain countries where Jews are not entitled to be citizens of that country. So I said, as I said at the beginning of these guidelines, if we mark Holocaust every year, both here in All Souls and nationally and throughout the world, then the greatest thing we can do to prove that we sincerely remember the Holocaust is to eradicate anti-Semitism. And now may we sing together our next hymn, Dear Lord and Father of Mankind.
Dear Lord and Father of Mankind, no place for the disabled. The Nazis decided that it was a waste of time and money to support the disabled during Hitler's cleansing program. Thousands of people with various handicaps were deemed useless and simply put to death, like dogs and cats. Backed by willing supporters in the medical, healthcare, and social service professionals, communities the Nazis viewed institutionalized people with disabilities perceived as congenital to be a threat to the gene pool of the so-called German master race. The Nazi leadership was determined to use the opportunity of war to physically alienate people with disability living in institutions but perceived as unable to work.
Priests and pastors died for their beliefs. Hitler wanted not only to conquer all of Europe, but he also wanted to create a new religion and to replace Jesus Christ as a person to be worshipped. Hitler expected his followers to worship the Nazi ideology. Since Catholic priests and Christian pastors were often influential leaders in their community, they were sought out by the Nazis very early. Thousands of Catholic priests and Christian pastors were forced into concentration camps. A special barracks was set up at Dachau, the camp near Munich, Germany, for clergymen. A few survived, some were executed, but most were allowed to die slowly of starvation and disease. We light this candle for all those of faith who perished.
Political and trade unionists, among the earliest victims of discrimination and persecution in Nazi Germany, were political opponents, primarily communists, socialists, social democrats, and trade union leaders. In 1933 to 1934, the German central government and various local governments, as well as local battalions of the Nazi stormtroopers and protection squads, established concentration camps throughout Germany to detain political prisoners. We light this candle in memory of all those humanists, non-religious, political, and trade unionists who were murdered during the Holocaust.
Like the Jews, the Roma Gypsies were chosen for total annihilation solely because of their race. Even though Jews are defined by religion, Hitler saw the Jewish people as a race that he believed needed to be completely annihilated. Likewise, the Roma Gypsies were a nomadic people that were persecuted throughout history. Both groups were denied certain privileges in many European countries. The Germans believed both the Jews and the Gypsies were racially inferior and degenerate, and therefore worthless. The Gypsies were also moved into special areas set up by the Nazis, and 500,000 of them, representing almost the entire Eastern European Gypsy population, was wiped out during the Holocaust. We light this candle for the Roma Gypsies who perished.
Poles who died. Of the 11 million people killed during the Holocaust, 6 million were Polish citizens, 3 million were Polish Jews, and another 3 million were Polish Christians. Most of the remaining victims were from other countries including Hungary, Czechoslovakia, Ukraine, Russia, Holland, France, and even Germany. We light this candle for the Polish people who perished.
Because Hitler's plan for a great master race had no room for any homosexuals, many males from all nations, including Germany, were persecuted, tortured, and executed. Hitler even searched his own men and found suspected homosexuals that were sent to concentration camps wearing their SS uniforms and medals. The homosexual inmates were forced to wear pink triangles on their clothes so they could be easily recognized and further humiliated inside the camps. Between 5,000 and 15,000 homosexuals died in concentration camps during the Holocaust. We light this candle for all the LGBT plus people who perished.
Writers and artists. The Nazis also persecuted authors and artists whose works they considered subservient, both Jewish and secular writers who opposed the Nazi system. We light this candle in memory of all those creative writers, artists, and intellectuals who died at the hands of the Nazi regime.
We remember all those who have died through ethnic cleansing and genocide, such as the Armenians, Rwandans, and recently Yazidis and Kurds. We call on our elected representative to speak out against such acts. We light this candle for all those who have died during genocides.
El Malay Rachamin, the Holocaust Memorial Prayer. El Malay Rachamin, God full of compassion, is a Jewish prayer for the departed that is recited at funeral services. Since the Holocaust, the prayer has been adopted as a memorial prayer for the victims of the Holocaust and of Nazi persecution. I shall read in Hebrew and then in English. El Malay Rachamin, Shokain Bamurim, Hatunu Menuka Nikula Al Hakpane Hashokino Bamalos Kadoshim Ushurim Hahu Horkagim Masharim Esh Nishmo Ehenu Bene Yisrael Hakodoshim Vahahurim Shefalonu Bide Harosihim Vinishvak Noma Bur Voship Shir Medegen Medleto Nikol Vishon Bahanos Pashmar Be'evrufa Shinehru Gu Shinehatu Vinishrefu Vishenefu Vishenehu Al Kadish Hashem Baval Shakal Hakol Hakodosh Hazer Maman Lihim Be'ain Hasakoras Nishmaso Begon Eder Sider Musutyato Lokain Ba'al Horahamin Yisorei b'sefer v'nofer li'olamim v'suro b'so ha'hayim es nishmoso Adonai hu v'holo v'nohu al mishros v'so v'shalom v'ne'amah amen. O God, who art full of compassion, who dwellest on high, grant perfect rest in thy divine presence to all the souls of our holy and pure brethren whose blood was spilt by the murderers in Auschwitz, Belzec, Bergen-Belsen, Dachau, Majdanek, Sobibor, Treblinka, and other extermination camps in Europe, who were killed, strangled, burned, and buried alive for the sanctification of thy name, for whose souls we now pray. May their resting place be in the Garden of Eden. May the Master of Mercy shelter them in the shadow of his wings for eternity, and may he bind their souls in the bond of life. Hashem is their heritage, and may they repose in peace in their resting places. Now let us say, Amen. We light this candle in memory of the 6 million Jews who perished.
Now may we sing together our next hymn, Guide Me, O Thou Great Jehovah. The blessing of truth be upon us, the power of love direct and sustain us, and may the peace of this community preserve our going out and our coming in from this time forth until we meet again. Amen. God bless you all.